Camera calibration is a big issue in computer stereo vision. Tiny variations of the camera alignment can decalibrate your camera setup, which makes image processing impossible. For a camera setup to function optimally, it should thus be frequently recalibrated. This, however, is time-consuming, and it is often difficult to recalibrate your cameras if you are in the field. To ease this burden, we have just enabled our SP1 stereo vision system to perform an automatic camera recalibration, which is done concurrently during normal image processing. The auto recalibration estimates the inter-camera rotation, which is usually the most fragile parameter of a camera setup. This estimation does not require any calibration pattern or user input. The cameras of this setup have been well calibrated, which we can infer from the density of the computed depth map. We can also verify the calibration if we open the review calibration page in the SP1's web interface and highlight some exemplary epipolar lines. Now, any point that is on one such line in the left image, like for example this corner here, also has to be on the same line in the right camera image, which you can see is clearly the case. Now, let's mess up the calibration. We can easily do so by loosening the mounting screws of one camera. As we can see, the depth map is now significantly corrupted. The new depth map only includes meshes for the most prevailing edges, and it includes some serious mismatches. We can again examine the calibration in the SP1's web interface. If we look closely at the same corner that we examined before, we can see that there is now a very slight difference in the corner's vertical position. This difference is sufficient for putting stereo matching off track. In order to fix the calibration, let's activate the new auto recalibration feature. We are able to configure the number of samples that the SP1 collects before it triggers a recomputation of the calibration parameters. Let's set this to a small value in order to provoke a fast recalibration. The system should now recalibrate itself within a few seconds. This happens fully automated without the need for any user interaction. Also, recalibration does not affect the current stream of depth data. As we can see, calibration has now successfully been restored. If we reload the web interface, we can get some information on the computed calibration update. In total, the inter-camera rotation has been corrected by 0.4 degrees. We also see a list of most recent rotation estimates, which are represented as rotation quaternions. If we navigate back to the review calibration page, we can see that our considered image corner is now again perfectly aligned. So what exactly is happening under the hood? Given an unrectified stereo image pair, the SP1 first identifies salient image features. Features from one image are then matched to the corresponding features from the respective other image. This is done with a relaxed epipolar constraint. Using robust estimation techniques, the SP1 is then able to infer the inter-camera rotation from the detected feature correspondences. If we combine this information with the camera's intrinsic parameters, which are known from manual camera calibration, we are able to perform stereo image rectification. The rectified image data is then used for robust and accurate stereo matching. This concludes the stereo auto recalibration demonstration. Thank you for watching.